All right, y'all. Today, I have a new special guest. Everybody's a special guest, apparently. No, I'm just kidding. I have a really special guest here. His name is Luh Tyler, coming out of South Florida and came out here and switched up the flows of a lot of the motion that we got in music right now. He's doing his own damn thing. And he's such a charming fella. Look at him. Look at him. Look at him. Look, let me gas you up. All right, Tyler, how you feeling today?
Good. Hey, we from North Florida, man.
North Florida? Damn, I said South Florida. North Florida. I said South Florida in the other interview, too. Remember that? You ain't correct me then, now.
At Rolling Loud?
Yeah, I did. You didn't catch it because we didn't have the mics on.
We even quit then, I ain't gonna
lie. We was. All right, well, welcome to the Pink Room. I already told you what it's about, so we're going to get right into it with the icebreaker song. I mean, the icebreaker question, but it's a song. All right. Think as far back as you possibly can. So when you was probably just starting to walk, crawling, whatever, being bad. What was the first song you can recall hearing?
First song I ever heard, because I don't know.
Think deep. Was you with your mama, your daddy? Was it with your cousins, your uncles? I don't know what your family looked like, but where was you at? Was it a cookout?
I don't even know.
You don't know, Tyler?
Damn.
If not the first song you remember, just the first song you think about right now then, from back in the day.
Oh, no.
Somebody said the other day, Barney. Like, it could be something
Barney,
like that.
Nah.
Damn, they probably have Barney. What did y'all have?
ABC's.
Okay, that's a good question. What children's shows was you watching?
Like, kids' shows?
Yeah.
PBS Kids. I don't even remember that because PBS Kids.
They had Arthur, didn't they?
I ain't watched that. I watched the, what's the turtle?
Ninja Turtles.
No, the other, you know what I'm, Franklin.
Franklin? There's a turtle named Franklin?
I used to watch that.
Oh, all right. All right, cool. So I don't know what song that goes to that. SpongeBob. All right, we all know SpongeBob. Yeah, SpongeBob been around for a long time then. He's still rolling? He got new episodes? Y'all know. All right, so that's the icebreaker. Just trying to get deep down into like where you first heard music and what you were listening to. Since you can't quite remember, I'm gonna just talk about some scenarios that you may have experienced as a youngin' and talking about the music that you would hear in it or around it. Was you in a church at all? Your mama have you in church? Your daddy had you in church?
when we was little, yeah, offense. My daddy.
Yeah. Was you active in the church? Did you sing? Did you dance? What you do in the church?
Nah, just sit quiet.
Damn. You was patient, huh? Because I was always complaining.
Because I think I was in Sunday school, too.
Yeah.
For 2 days.
Vacation Bible study, all that
stuff?
Yeah, that.
Vacation Bible study.
Mm-hmm. How old were you when you was doing that? Like six?
Probably like eight, six.
Yeah. Okay, that was young. All right, well, shoot, you got any siblings or?
Yeah, I got two sisters.
Okay, so what was they listening to? Destiny Child? Like, I know they was listening to some stuff.
Mackenzie, she know all the old songs.
Yeah.
See, my other sister, I know she know all the old songs. Yeah.
What would you hear around the house, though? What would you hear around the house?
Cotton candy. Like that.
What's that?
But you don't know that?
Cotton candy. See, no, now, I don't know. Look, don't do that to me.
Y'all be talking
he
about me.
Too much trying to tell me about it.
What's the name of that? Who sing that?
I don't know.
Or that, damn. Damn, what's that one song?
I can't recall it either. You know what? I wonder what's...
Damn. Bill Withers, Lovely Day.
Oh.
They playing like that, too.
Oh, Ebony, Ivory. Wait, that's not it.
I can't even remember how that bit go right now.
Me either. I know what you mean. Yeah. The lovely. There we go. Thank y'all. Yeah. I'm over here saying Ebony Ivory. What is wrong with me? Okay.
Lovely.
So yeah, that was like a little bit old school, like that old school music for real. And that was coming from your sisters or your family?
My family.
Yeah, in general. We all have cookouts and stuff. What do you remember hearing or being around?
Cotton candy. Whoever seen that.
We need to figure out who that is. What song that is.
Any cookout, I hear that bit.
Every time?
Yeah.
What was just some of your favorite memories?
When am I going to stop new show? I hear that every time, too. Who that is? King George.
I don't know that one either. Why are we looking at him? Are you looking it up?
No, I don't know.
Oh, he ain't looking it up.
Yeah. All right. So, all right. We talked about your sisters and being at the cookout and stuff like that. But when did you first realize your appreciation for music? Like, when you realized you wanted to do it, or was it something that you actually had a knack for? Because you ain't never wrote no songs. So clearly you got some little musical geniusness in there.
Nah, I was just trying it. Then when I seen people liking it, then I had some appreciation for it.
Ah, interesting. So when you were just trying it, and now we're at square one, segment of square one. When you were just trying it, talk to me about, like, what inspired you to start trying it?
My friends are rapping, and, like, listening to people from my city who are rapping. Mm-hmm. Yeah. They just told me to try it, because they were rapping on their phone, too.
And then you started with Van Lab. Yeah. Okay, so you were just like, let me get on this. I got some motion. Let me, you know. And then people started liking it. And then that's when you started appreciating it. So mm-hmm. did you, and I asked this because clearly you have to understand music enough to be able to have the kind of flow that you do and the ride on the beats like you do or whatever. What did you listen to that was like, I don't want to say your influences, but like what kind of music were you listening to from like ages 10 to 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, whatever age. Yeah.
Then by then I used to be listening to Youngboy by then. Youngboy. LPB Pooty, you know who that is?
No, I don't know who that is. Where are you from?
He from Orlando.
From Orlando. Glock, I don't know about Glock 9. I'm about to say Glock 9.
He from Orlando, Hot Boy.
Florida got a lot. I know Hot Boy. I know Hot Boy, Miami ish.
Nah, Orlando.
Orlando for real?
Yeah.
Okay. Damn, Orlando got a lot
Rico
going
Cartel,
on.
Rico Cartel, he from Orlando, too. That I would listen to him.
I've only been to Orlando once.
Who else? I don't even know. One Way Frank.
Damn, he put me on a lot.
Yeah, he had like, he don't even rap no more, though, I don't think.
Was he an old head?
Nah.
Okay.
He just don't rap no more, I guess. But that boy was hard, though.
So when you first got... I know there was iPhones by this point, I'm sure. So it wasn't like you got an iPod, like back in the day, like we did. When you got an iPhone and you start putting music on it, or listening to music.
I did have an iPod.
You did? Okay, yeah. Look, you see his face. He's looking at me like, girl. No, you did have an iPod. Okay, so you had the one with the touchscreen, didn't you?
Yeah.
Yeah, that was the
one. What's the little MP3 player?
Napster? No.
What's that bit called? I forgot.
I forgot too. I don't have a good memory either. We both can't remember. No. So when you first started listening to music though on your phone and stuff, what was on it? Like if you go open your iPod from whatever year it was, what kind of songs is on it? What kind of artists were you playing?
Same artist I just named. Like,
same one you just
Glock 9 them.
So you literally came
Young
out
boy.
Or from a you're a product of like the music and the sound that you heard.
Rod Wave back then I might have been.
He might have been. Nah.
Well now a 10 on thing. So.
Nah, never mind. That was a minute ago.
I wouldn't listen to him when I was 10.
Yeah.
On thing, so I don't even know.
Have you started listening to different styles of music and different artists since you've gotten into this now?
Yeah.
Like who?
Yeah. Like Trippie Redd, Yeet. I ain't really like Yeet that for it, but nah, I like it.
Yeah.
It just growed on me.
Yeah, it does grow on you. It took me a minute too.
You listen to Yeet?
Not for my own pleasure.
Right.
Yeah. But
I ain't gonna lie, I listen to him now.
His music sounds like a spaceship to me. And someone explained it to me one day that was like, sometimes I don't feel like, you know, the prolific sounds and like lyricism and stuff. I want to feel like I'm taking off in another place.
It just had the right time.
Yeah. All right. So that was what you were listening to then. What you listen to now. Obviously, you make your own music too or whatever. But like, I want to talk about some references from other styles of music too. Like any like R&B artists that you listen to.
Billie Eilish.
Will we consider her R&B? She's not rap.
Yeah.
She do her own thing. Damn. So no Chris Brown? I'm just kidding.
Nah.
Brett Fayez.
Nah, that boy Kuda. Yeah, Brett Fayez.
Yeah. Who else on the toxic rappers or toxic R&B side?
Broadway. Let's see.
Oh, yeah.
No cap. That boy not. He ain't R&B. But he kind of.
I just found out about him. No cap. Because his song played after you on YouTube. Like, you know what like the YouTube algorithm is. That's funny you mentioned it.
That man's so big. I don't know. Well, I be thinking, I don't know. I know a lot of people don't know him, though.
Yeah, it's a lot of music out here, though. Like, with what I do in my position, like, I mean, really, that platform is a portal of music. Like, I get on there, somebody I didn't know or heard of, and they got 50,000 followers or whatever.
You know who Rallo is?
Yeah. Rallo Rodriguez?
Yeah.
Okay. I'm from Atlanta,
Number.
They similar?
Yeah, they get, that's like.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I feel like when I saw
duo,
when I saw him, he looked like him a little bit, at least from what I saw.
I don't know about that. I don't know.
When I was glancing at the TV, when I was trying to get dressed. That's what I saw. Okay, so then we still in square one because we got to get down to the first song, the first song. And I know you say you ain't never wrote a song before, but you did put pen to paper and write something. You had to put something down. When was the first time you wrote something? Even if that was the first time you wrote.
First time I wrote something?
Yeah, first time. Even if it was just now, just yesterday. I don't know. The first time you wrote something, just the first.
Damn. What?
You ain't wrote nothing. You don't need to write.
Nah. Damn. I ain't wrote nothing but like two lines.
That's crazy.
Just so I wouldn't forget them. It was probably like
what two lines was that?
Catch a punch line or something.
What two lines were they?
Yeah. I'm trying to think what song.
It's all right. It's all right.
I think it's on with Trackland. I think I wrote down. Let me get a pad like on Trackland. I remember write that down.
Yeah, okay.
So I won't forget it.
All right.
So when I hit the studio.
So you don't, you it all comes to you when you get in the booth, when you get in the studio. Your first time recording, tell me about that experience.
In my room on the bed?
No, in like a studio.
In the studio?
Yeah, in the studio. You don't remember?
I do. But I ain't like it at first though. Cause I wasn't there, I wasn't trying to rap in front of nobody.
Because you were used to doing it in your bed, right?
Yeah.
Yeah. Interesting. How was you feeling when you first heard yourself on like in the mic or in like the headphones? So did you,
I was like, nah, it don't sound the same. I was like, nah.
Mm-hmm.
But then after doing it for a while, then I like, nah.
Yeah, I mean, yeah. We see that. That's wonderful though. All right, so first time in the studio. All right, let's talk about your first performance.
Strip club.
For real? You could get in the strip club? I guess if you perform it. Hey, man, I ain't complaining. All right. Tell me about that experience. First time performing.
It wasn't a lot of people there at all. Yeah, it was
the
in
strippers
West Palm
was
Beach.
There, though.
Yeah. It was in West Palm Beach. But, like, ain't nobody know the song. Like, that was then. Like, everybody just looking tight. They don't know the song. They just bobbing.
What you perform?
Law and Order.
Oh, ooh, that's back. Okay. Well, shoot, that wasn't that long ago. How long ago was it? Like, no more than, like, a year?
I love how he do this. Not that wasn't that long ago.
It wasn't that long ago, because Law & Order dropped last summer. No, Law & Order.
But that feel like a long time, though.
It do. I'm ready for this year to be over already. Damn. All right, so, because I was trying to figure out, like, were you... That little boy that was going around rapping when you was younger and like always on everybody's. Okay, I could see that now talking to you more. Like, you really just like, let me try. And then it worked. And then you like, yeah. Ski. We're here. And I ain't going back. We ain't going back.
Yeah.
That's interesting though, because again, like you saying that you don't really, you don't write for real. Like,
nah.
You just get in there and you just go off.
Yeah.
But what the hell are you going through your head? Like, how do those words come out of you? Like, do you kind of set a tone for, like, I know the story I want to tell today, or you just get in there and it just flows?
I just got to hit a beat, then I come up with a first line, then go out the first line, whatever I first say. And then I be trying to think, like, catch it the funny. Where, like, people gonna remember?
Yeah, yes. That's one thing I love about
you. Or I might hit TikTok or something like that. Mm-hmm. A line or something.
So then how do you go from not writing and then, like, recording, but then, like, having to remember it so you gotta perform it? What's in your brain?
Oh, I don't know. I just remember all of them after I do it.
That's crazy. Do you know how crazy that is? I'm looking at you. Well, who am I looking at? Sorry. That's wild. No, that's a good thing. Like, that's.
But if it's not planned, then sometimes I forget it. But if it's planned, then I remember it. Like, if I hear it, then I'm going to remember it.
I might come back to that because that's a very interesting point. Like, you haven't not necessarily had too much exposure to music outside of what you fed yourself. And it was limited, in my opinion. And then now you're in this space where you just walk in, you just flow, let it out, and you can remember it. That's a God's gift right there. That's very, very gifted. Very, very gifted. All right. So we're going to split up the segments, or we're going to cut to another segment, but we're going to do a little scene first. But let me ask you some questions real quick because I got to figure out what you be doing. Like, do you skateboard? What kind of hobbies you have? Not saying you look like a skateboarder. It does give a little bit, but it's okay. Nah. What are your hobbies, Tyler? What do you do? What's something you want to see right now or do right now to take yourself away from music, like a break?
What's them on? You know, in the sand dune where they riding the four wheelers and the ATVs.
Yeah, vroom, like vroom. All right, we're gonna go there.
Come on, vroom.
Okay. Sit like this, not Indian style. You don't gotta cross your leg.
Like, this girl's crazy. How about to say
that? You don't hate me after this.
Too far, nah.
All right, put your palms up to the sky like this. Relax your shoulders, lay back. Sit back. I'm gonna talk to you, and you're gonna hear it in the ear. But, like, relax your shoulders a little bit. Close your eyes. We are in, a meditative pose. This is called Shavasana. But really, like, true Shavasana is on the ground. But I'm going to talk to you. Close your eyes. I'm going to, like, speak the scene out. I don't really even know what I'm going to say. But I'm going to just flow like you, right? Okay. All right, Tala. We in Dubai. We in the sand dunes going crazy. It's you, your partners. Y'all might got a couple of ladies with y'all. One of each little dune car or whatever. It's hot as outside, but y'all lit, y'all happy to go because you finally get to go to the sand dunes and you riding crazy fast, crazy reckless on your crazy. What song is playing as you going crazy in the sand dunes?
Pop with me and Anti.
Okay, that's appropriate. That's very appropriate. He might be there with you.
You might be there.
Yeah. All right, that's appropriate. But you see what I did? I was trying to like talk you into. You know, the scene, so you could get relaxed in
a
it.
A little cute word.
Yeah.
Nah. I'll pitch in a little bit.
Yeah, a little bit. A little bit. I don't really know what the dunes look like outside of what I've seen on TikTok, so that was just my best interpretation. All right, Papa, you an Anti. All right, now from...
You know that song?
I've heard it, but I don't remember it.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah. I remember seeing that on the track list for first show, and I was like, oh, yeah, gotta listen to one with Anti on it. Not square one. Where we at now? We are at the brink, though. Okay, so the brink is all about, like, literally your breakout moment in culture. And we kind of already know the story from Law and Order and then really just kind of breaking out through that. But maybe I'm going to twist this up. Not twist it. I'm going to switch it up for you. And we can just talk about where you are now and, like, all the things you learned from Law and Order dropping, you pressing send on your phone or whatever Band Lab got to now. Like, what are some things you want to talk about that you've experienced?
Billboard, boy, I ain't think I hit Billboard.
Really?
Yeah, that's a problem.
Yeah. Where did it peak at?
Shauna.
Yeah, damn. I didn't know that. That's what's up. Yeah. It's a Billboard.
Yeah, I won't really be surprised by it for real, but that's surprising.
Yeah.
Well, I'd be surprised, but I won't really be getting too excited or nothing like that.
You don't, do you? What excites you? Money?
Yeah.
Ski. You want to do that so bad. So what are you proud of right now for yourself? What is victory?
I'm proud of everything.
Okay.
But I just don't be too
excited.
Yeah.
How do you
too
celebrate?
Cocky. I just be humble.
Nah, hold on now.
I don't even really celebrate, cuz.
What, Tyler? Do you know how much you got to celebrate? Do you know you can walk in a room and just say out your head and it hits number two on Billboard charts? You know how wild that is?
Cause I still sometimes, like, when a crowd, big crowd, I still be nervous cause I be like, damn, do they, because I don't know.
Everybody you talk.
You know what I'm saying? I be nervous cause I don't know.
That means you still really close to your craft though. You're not really like, you don't need the external stuff to really, yeah, you get what I'm saying. Yeah, damn, we got a lot to celebrate. All right, hold on. Where how did we get there? We were talking about lessons learned and like things that, you know, have surprised you along your path now. You talk about Billboard. What are some some like I don't want to say relationships, but like who are some maybe like old heads or people you looked up to that like gave you advice that really stuck with you?
Damn. You said old.
Well, hold on. Let me not call them old heads because they probably my age.
Sean Kingston, how old he is? He ain't really an old head. He's old.
Dog.
How old Sean Kingston is?
I don't know, but he's probably 30. He's probably my age.
Y'all ain't old heads, but yeah, y'all good, huh? 30?
We good. Y'all good. We good.
Y'all good, man. But yeah, that boy. Damn, what Sean Kingston told
me? What'd he say?
Yeah, you be like, man, keep running that back. I don't know, cuz that boy, I ain't even know Sean King's Jamaican like that. That boy,
oh, he is?
Yeah, that boy got to talk in Jamaican, cuz the little accent, I can't even do it. But he was just telling me, keep running, doing what I'm doing.
Where did you see him at?
That boy took me to his crib. I was on the flight. Then I had went to go use the bathroom. Then he seen my ass, but then he was like, Luh Tyler. But then I had looked at him. I ain't really recognize. I'm thinking he just like, look, I don't know, a regular fan, because I just kept going to the bathroom. Then when the plane landed, I had got out, then I had seen him. Then he was like, where's Kingston?
Then that dog.
Boy told me to pull up to his crib.
Yeah.
Then me and Shimmy, Eloise, and we pulled up on him.
Damn, all right. Who else? So Sean Kingston, that's a very random one to me.
Yeah, Sean Kingston.
Yeah, you seen him on the plane, right?
Yeah. Well, another old. Who is old?
Hold on, like, let's not call him old heads. I'm sorry. I didn't mean to do that to us.
This one old for Scarface.
Oh, okay. Yeah.
He old.
OG. OG. No, he not old head. He OG.
Yeah.
What you say?
This one I was first blowing up. I don't know. Nigga called my mama. I don't even know how my mama got his number or whatever. But they were chopping it up. I don't know. He was just like, don't let them labels trick you, bro. Don't let. Whatever. I forgot what he was saying. He was like, make sure you sign the right deal. Don't let them label. You tell me about 360s and all that. I ain't need nobody.
Yeah. It's real out here. What made you go with where you went?
Good deal. And Auntie Shana, man, I got
yes,
good.
Yes, there
got
she
good
go.
People rhyming.
Better action. Well, that's first act. First show. Back in action. All right. So
you talking about first show beat?
Yeah, that's stuck in my head. I don't know why. It reminds me of something I feel like I would hear my mama playing or something like that.
You think that's a summer song?
Excuse me, you said what?
You think that's a summer song?
I don't know. Your songs don't have a season to me. That's not a bad thing.
Oh, right. I just be making music.
Right, exactly. You can tell. You see making music. All right, so now I want to talk about... You know what? No, we're going to play a game first before we switch to the next segment. Okay, this one, I'm just going to say phrases, names, artists, words, and you just name a song that you think of when you hear this verse. Or this much we'll call it. Jada Waiter.
Name a song, what I think of that?
Yeah.
Or that person? Jada Waiter, my song.
Damn, that was too easy. Damn, I forgot. I thought you were going to say like, my boo, or something like that.
What?
That was Chris Brown. No, Usher. Wow, I'm
what
off.
What they
got to
do with
today.
Jada Waiter?
I don't know. Crushing? You was crushing, maybe? maybe not.
Come on.
All right. Let's do the Lakers. Well, that's random, but you don't give up with
the Lakers.
They not doing too good right now.
Oh, I got a song. Can't even name this. I said it's about the Lakers.
Okay, all right. Yeah. It don't gotta be one of your songs, Tyler. It could be any song in the world.
Lakers, by Rico Cartel.
Okay, all right, bet. All right, Jamaica.
Jamaica, damn.
Yeah. You can't say Sean Kingston either.
Yeah, Sean Kingston. The beautiful girls.
Beautiful girls. Yeah. We could just say that one.
Beautiful girls, Sean Kingston.
All right. Have you ever modeled before?
Modeled?
Yeah. Have you had any modeling looks or anything? I could see you on like a runway show. Not like on the like crazy weird tour stuff. But what song would we playing if he was running walking down the runway?
Feeling peachy, Kodak.
Okay. Ooh, I like that one by Kodak. You didn't say Kodak earlier.
About what?
About music you was listening to.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, you ain't.
Man,
that's
yeah,
kind
yeah,
of implied.
Yeah. You know, man, everybody know that.
Everybody know Kodak. Name him. What's your favorite Kodak song?
Boy, that hard. I don't even know. That Rocky Man hard, nah.
I don't think I heard that one.
But it's not that bad. Damn. I don't know. I like that old skirt, skirt.
Yeah.
I'm busting out of
bed. Skirt, skirt. Yeah, man. Damn, that took me back a little bit. I don't know when that came out, but I think I was in college. Or no, I was just getting outside, out of college.
Yeah.
Just getting outside in Atlanta. I lived in Atlanta for 10 years.
What college you went to?
I went to Spelman. I got Spelman Blue on. That's our little sign. Shout out to 2013. Y'all reunion going on right now. Yeah, no, I went to college in Atlanta, so I was around a lot of, like, Travis Porter and Roscoe Dash and Waka Flocka and what's his name? Amigos, you know, RIP, hang off. But,
oh, yeah, the Amigos, I was listening to them, boy.
Okay, yeah. All right. That was still, y'all was, you was going, were you going to Atlanta back when you was living in North Florida?
Hell nah. Only been to,
Damn, hell nah.
Nah, we just ain't never go out there. I'm trying to think. First time I went to Atlanta, I think it was like, it was some music.
Yeah, that makes sense.
Yeah.
That was probably a year ago. Less than that, huh?
A couple months ago.
Like, damn.
Seven. Nah, maybe a year ago. I ain't gonna lie.
You just getting out here, Tyler.
I can't even remember because it feels so long ago. Days to be going by.
Yeah, it feels like it's just been a lot going on in music over the last... It was weird because we had the pandemic, right? And then all of a sudden, like, things was, like, let out again. There's shows, there's events and stuff like that. And then new artists started breaking through and doing shows and stuff like that. So for me, it's been, like, a whirlwind. And I'm sure it feels like that for you, too. But through all that, how are you maintaining and, like, keeping your peace through it if you are... Are you?
Yeah.
You seem pretty, like, unbothered.
I be chilling.
You be chilling? Man, that's that spirit, man, that younger spirit. Because I know, I wish, as much as I be chilling, I'm thinking about my phone going off. I'm thinking about stuff right now. Obviously, I'm here with you and we're present, but I'm saying,
nah,
like,
I be worried about it, though, but it be like.
What you be worried about?
I don't know. Well, it be like. Like, if I'm finna do a freestyle for, like, and it's off the head or something, like, when I did On the Radar, I ain't gonna lie, I was nervous.
Now, how are you nervous for that when that's really what you do in a booth by yourself?
Yeah, but, like, it's different, though, because I punch in.
Oh, got you. Okay.
Like, I ain't just going straight through the whole song.
I like that Cash beat. I worked with him before. When I heard that, I could tell that was, like, I like plug beats.
Yeah.
So... When I heard you on that, I think that was my first time hearing you on a plug beat.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
I got a lot of unreleased plugs on them.
Ooh, can't wait to hear that. I love that. You slid on that. So you was nervous, but you slid on that. I remember people talking about, like, damn, that's a beat we never heard him on before.
Yeah.
Whatever. We talked about what you're proud of, what you're worried about. What else? I'm trying to think. This particular one has been all over the place because I got to dig for you. But outside of kind of like your breakout moments in culture, which was Law and Order, at least for me, I guess the greater culture, maybe it's now with like the project and everything. But now if you look at where you are now and looking around, I guess, the entertainment space, are there any like trends or like certain things that you notice that are working from the marketing for your music or anything like that?
TikTok.
What about TikTok? I love when y'all talk about TikTok because it's always
something
new. I don't
even like TikTok.
Why not?
Well, I do, but nah, not really. Like, I don't like posting on it. Like, I probably scroll on it, but I don't like doing it. I ain't really dancing type of guy.
Yeah, I'm about to say I ain't never heard you
like doing no dances or none of that. Like,
You just cool. You just be chilling.
Yeah.
You just be chilling. Yeah. No, okay. So when you first, how did you actually recap this to me? When you dropped Law and Order, did it go on TikTok first or no?
I put it on YouTube and SoundCloud.
Yeah. I think I remember seeing it in the video. When did you shoot the video for that?
I shot it wait, damn. A couple months, like after it. Yeah.
Okay, after it kind of picked up the motion.
Yeah.
I think I didn't see it. I didn't hear it until I saw the video. Yeah. Okay, so I was late. It's all right.
Not really.
It's only been...
A couple months.
10 months in total? 10 months?
Oh, since I dropped it, yeah. It's been like 11 years, 10 months.
Yeah, Yeah, see, my memory's okay now. All right, so you say TikTok. What other, like, I guess not popular topics, but other trends in entertainment space right now is something that you've been paying attention to or that catches your eye? It could be anything from, like, the new Jersey Club sound that's being spread throughout everything. Yo, your Bad Bunny just dropped a song with Jersey Club beats in it.
Who is Jersey Club?
Jersey Club, the sound. Have you rapped over Jersey Club beat? Have I heard? No, I don't think so.
Oh, your producer?
No, it's literally a sound. Like, too rare.
Oh, like Uzi. TikTok. I just wanna rock. TikTok type beats.
Yeah, technically, yeah. It's going on TikTok now. Okay, yeah. Okay, so...
So you ask for like techniques.
I
want to
hear you on
blow.
One of those. Not techniques to make your song blow. I'm just saying, just certain. You see how like the I don't want to say history repeats itself because it does, but there's kind of a wave of music that's like experimenting a lot more with different sounds. Like before, when I was getting ready and watching YouTube and stuff, then there was a Bad Bunny song that was a YouTube. I mean, that has a Jersey Club beat or Jersey Club structure to it. You put it that way. And I would have never guessed his sound would sound good on that, but it did. And I'm like, what other things have you noticed that like you might want to try out in your music based on stuff that's going on?
Auto-tune, but like when I first started, I was like, hell no, cause I don't even like auto-tune. Cause I don't really listen.
You don't put auto-tune in. Do you put auto-tune in music?
I ain't dropped nothing with no auto-tune, that's but I got like two songs with auto-tune.
No, don't do it if you don't want to. I love when people don't lean on auto-tune.
You don't like auto-tune?
I can hear it. Like, listening to you talk to me right now, you sound like what you sound like on your songs. And I like that. Because your voice has its own unique texture to it that don't nobody else have. And that's what, I think that's also kind of what makes it funny when I'm listening to your rhymes and stuff is because, like, you really just be talking and there's a beat playing. Kind of.
I do talk on the beat with a flow
and, like, with a swag to it.
Yeah.
Don't lose that if you get too auto-tuned. But I guess, you know, experiment if you want to. That's just
my
take.
Nah, it
wasn't,
like, I'm rapping. Like, I don't know.
Oh, you talking about some T-Pain.
Not that far. I'm playing for you after this.
Okay. Play for tomorrow.
I got you.
Yeah. Okay. Bet. All right. Auto-tune. All right. So... After that segment, we can talk about what's next for you. And really, you know, you had the project drop. How long ago? Like a month ago? Well, the deluxe.
Yeah, probably about a month or two.
Yeah. But what's next for you? What are some things you're looking forward to in the next year before it flies?
That wasn't no deluxe. That was a
deluxe.
Reloaded. I'm trying.
Is there a deluxe coming? Okay, that's what I thought. That's why I said that.
I'm trying to get that out.
No, so what's next for you, though? I know I asked you what are your goals next, but like, not even just goals. Like,
what I'm doing next?
Yeah, what you doing next? Are you in any movies? You, yeah, what you doing? Where are we gonna see you at? Where can we find you?
I got two movie offers, but bro, I ain't gonna lie, I can't be in no serious like role type, bro. Like, bro, that ain't me. Like, my people be telling me like that's a good opportunity. I gotta do it because it's a movie, but.
You never know, Tyler. Look, I'm going to tell you this. The fact that you can do what you do and you can go into a booth and just spit and bring, words come out your mouth, that means you got a lot of unlocked talent.
But that's what I want to do that because I ain't really say like, I probably said I want to be in a movie, but bro, I was probably just saying that because like, I don't really.
Well, you can get in the movie.
Look at you. I got two off of them, but.
Yeah. Well, we hope to see you on screen. I would love to see you in
all the time. I got to do some comedy, bro. Oh, I'm already nervous because like I ain't gonna be able to. I ain't gonna be able to be serious.
Yeah, no, I can see you in some comments, something really funny.
Yeah, because you don't even really gotta be serious.
Yeah, what sports do you play? Do you play any sports?
I used to play basketball.
Basketball. Okay. All right. I don't know why I asked that. I don't know why I thought that. That was a random question.
You played sports?
Mm-hmm. I ran track and I cheered. That was my thing. I was a cheerleader. Ran track, and I played soccer for a little bit when I was younger.
I played soccer when I was little too.
Yeah, but. I wasn't that good, and I ate all the oranges. You used to have the oranges on the sidelines?
Oranges? Remember that? I used to hit out of your stomach up.
No.
Orange juice.
Well, maybe actually, maybe now we know that that's a problem. Now that I think about it, that's why I wasn't that good. I was outside, I was tearing them oranges up.
Yeah,
having a blast.
With an upset stomach.
We ain't had oranges like that at home. I just go to the game and it's a whole.
We ain't had oranges like that.
Go to the game and it's a whole chest full of them. And Gatorades, the blue Gatorades.
You talking about them little oranges?
Was it a little ones? I think so, yeah. You know, you tear them hoes up too, don't you? Yeah.
They straight. I like peaches.
Peaches.
I like strawberry.
Okay. I like kiwi and watermelon.
Pineapple.
Pineapple. We gonna write a song about kiwi, watermelon, pineapple now. Okay. This is really fun for me because I'm all over the place, but I'm enjoying the conversation. However, do you have any questions for me? I'm ready for you to ask me questions about me and music.
How long you been interviewing people?
10 years.
10 years.
Not this though. I started out with this podcast called Urban Overdose on Live Hip Hop Daily. Shout out to H. He always said I was going to be a star. He was right. I didn't know it back then, but I know now. I started out doing that, and then I was also like, I was working a 9-to-5 bartending, waitressing in Atlanta, and I met someone, and they was like, oh, you should do this for my thing. And I'm like, bet. I can get it on events now. So it was fun. But then I started realizing I was really good at talking to people, and then I love music, so.
I was about to say, because I could not, like. I don't know.
You know what?
I don't even really like talking like that, so I couldn't probably be on no podcast interviewing people. I wouldn't even know what to ask.
Really?
Yeah.
You are you curious about people at all? No.
Sometimes, uh-huh. Nah.
Okay.
Nah, not really.
You gotta be a shorty or something, huh?
Huh?
You gotta be a shorty or something, huh?
Yeah.
No, because I used to think we would go out to eat, you know, on that one day that we could do it on the month, my family go out to eat for dinner. And I would see the waitresses, and I'd be like, I could never just walk up to people and talk to them. I literally did not know I was like this for a long time. Not until I got to Spelman. And that's why the school means a lot to me, because you get into this place, and it's like all these people just as smart, beautiful, as talented as you, probably come from more money and more resources than you, at least in my situation. And then you got to, like, be yourself. Like, you're not just the black girl anymore in school. Like, you know?
Yeah.
So I started talking to people, and look at me now. But, yeah. That's how long I've been interviewing people. 10 years.
Who you be listening to?
Who I listen to?
Yeah.
I've been listening to Coco Jones a lot. I definitely just ran through that summer. Yeah, I love me some Coco Jones. Ran through Summer's last project. I listen to Callie a lot now. I've always been a fan of her, but that the area code, you on the area codes remix too. I just like her. She I can relate to her a little bit.
Yeah, she hard.
You know, she hard. That was what's recent. Shoot, I would have to look at my phone. I listen to a lot of old stuff, though. Like, I really will just go home and listen to, like, Usher. And Brent, don't look at me like that.
Nah. Girl, do that, though.
Yeah. I don't, like, there's not much. When I'm listening to new stuff, it's because, all right, Summer dropped a project. Of course, I'm going to go listen to that. Or even Alex Vaughn. Now, she's on LBRN as well. But when I'm in my spaces, like this past weekend after the fight, my homie had like a fight party situation. I came home, you know, sipping some wine and stuff and doing some smoking weed and whatever. And I'm just like, I love feeding myself music. Like all the stuff that like I used to listen to growing up. Because when I got my first Walkman, you know what that is? The headphones and the CD player?
Hell no, I don't know what that is.
When I got my first one.
How long ago?
This was 25 years ago.
25 years, man.
At least like 20 years ago. I know you wasn't. But I'm just, I don't know. Stuff being around still. But I got my first one, though. I remember my mama took us to the end cap of like Walmart or Target or something. Probably Walmart. And where they had the CDs. And she just bought all the CDs at the time. But it was Brandy and Alicia Keys and Usher and Monica in there. Tony Braxton. So I didn't even know who those people were. They just looked like black queens. You know?
Yeah.
The album art.
Yeah.
And so, like, I'm playing them, going to sleep, listening to a new one every night. And that's how I fell in love with music, really, by just the end cap and the artwork. And then Walkman, it happened. It worked for me.
Well, the artwork, gotta have a heart. Gotta have a hard cover.
Gotta have a hard cover. And I was young back then. I didn't see stuff like that. Like, I really didn't even see black women in, like, a light like that outside of sitcoms.
Yeah.
But then also, I was watching The Wire back then too, though, I think.
The Wire.
Actually, was it that long?
I know that.
I might be tripping. I don't know. I honestly, the days and the years are going by so fast. I don't even know what today is. But anyways, I feel like that's... Any more questions? You got any more questions for me? I know you got one banger. It's something fun.
Where you used to work at for you doing this?
I do work. I mean, I do work at 9 to 5. Technically, that's not a 9 to 5. It's a lifestyle. But I work at SoundCloud and Artist Relations. And then I just...
Bro, I'm saying before that, bro.
Okay, you said before that. Well, I used to work at Home Depot corporate. I was in like the carpet department as a marketing coordinator for Home Depot. Literally, the worst job ever. And not the worst job. I'm sorry. Shout out to the people who were like, that's their thing. But I started my career in like corporate music because one day, and it was during the inauguration, everybody was watching the inauguration and I felt just like this energy of like, I don't want to be here. Like, yeah. I'm in my cubicle. I hear it from all of us. The Trump inauguration, obviously. Yeah. And then I get up. I'm like going down to the cafeteria, put my headphones on, and one of like the OGs in the department, who she was trying to make me her little minion, but I wasn't going for it. She was like, you shouldn't be listening to music on campus. Like that's unprofessional. And I'm like what? This is my blood. Like this is my my oxygen. This is my air. Like I need to get out of this little space right here where I hear Trump's voice everywhere. Sorry, political views, but whatever. Either way, so I left that and I quit my job. Damn, I don't know if my daddy knows I actually quit. I did quit. I didn't get laid off or fired. I did quit.
Oh, you told him you got fired. Huh?
Yeah. I quit. And then I was like, let me just keep bartending again on the side. I was always hustling and doing stuff. Bartending. And then I was like, let me just get a job in music, like at a company that makes music. And then I started working for Pandora. And then I started working for SoundCloud. And I'm here now.
That's hard.
Yeah, man. So we outside. I'm doing my thing. You doing your thing too. This was a fun interview. It was really hard, but it was fun.
Why it was hard?
Cause you don't talk like that. We talking though. We talking. I'm not gonna let you sit here and you're not gonna talk. That's the beauty of my job.
Yeah, you know how to keep a conversation.
Yeah, there we go. That's all I mean. But like it's fun for me just because I like to have conversations with people of different experiences with music. So you talking about like what was on your iPod, I'm like, damn, like where the Chris Brown and the Brandy at? Like I gotta like stop leaning on them. But even still, like Britney Spears or like Insane.
Nah.
Or like Adele, okay.
That hello. Man, when that shit was like, yeah. But I don't listen to no old music now. Like I listen to straight Lucky V's, Wiz. So you know who Lucky is?
Lucky, yeah, from Chicago. Yeah. He's a big underground artist. Damn, Tyler, you gotta, you know what? Maybe not at this stage, but I love to like listen to music with people and like study like old R&B and like the rhythms and the flows and stuff like that. Cause a lot of that goes in, the reason why everybody's sampling it to this day, because that is timeless.
Yeah.
So you gotta study kind of like the different structures and sequences of the notes and the flows and the patterns and stuff. There's something really deep in that music that is, you know, it transcends, you know, history.
For sure.
So if you want to be timeless, you got to dig into your roots.
Gotcha.
It goes far back. But I say all that to say I appreciate you and your talent, no matter how much you've experienced certain music or not experienced it. Because, again, I'm just still blown away by the fact that you don't be writing. Like, I get so nervous when I be freestyling. And, yeah, I do be freestyling with my friends. Yeah, we be acting a fool.
Freestyling?
Mm-hmm. Drea the Slayer, Slayer get slayed. You don't want me to slay you on the mic. No, ooh. You definitely could kill me though. I'm not even gonna go against you. No, I just like I like music too. Like I be making music with my friends just because we just got equipment and we like to hear ourselves on the mic and we just got to talk. Like that's why I was asking you. Like, do you know what story you're gonna tell or do you know what you're thinking? Because I know when I'm in it, they'll be like, man, I'm gonna talk about this today, like or this text message that I just sent.
See,
or,
I can't. I can, but I just be talking about everything in one. Like,
yeah, you do.
People be making a song like they focus on one thing. That'd be hard though. When you tell the story with that big focus on.
Yeah, like you know, Future recorded thought it was a drought after just effing somebody's beat, literally. Yeah. He's like, I just feel in some Gucci flip flop, and then that was his first line, and it went off for there. So yeah, experiment with your sound and stuff like that, and dig back into some of that old school music. I'm telling you, you won't feel something different. You probably didn't feel before. All right. But thank you for coming to the Pink Room with me.
For sure. This has
been a nice little adventurous conversation. I appreciate you and what you're doing with music and what you're doing with your flow. It definitely kind of brings me back to like, I don't want to call it Dr. Seuss, but like, You know what I mean. It's lyrical, a different lyrical structure that I'm not used to, and that's not being shoved down my throat all day, every day. So I appreciate you, bro. And thank you for coming.
Appreciate you.
We out. Peace.